I want a lot for Christmas. I need a lot. I care about the presents. I want more for Christmas than you. I want presents. Good morning to you. Good afternoon. Good evening. It's midweek, December the 21st, 2011. I am D. Martez, your host. Also your brother, cousin, uncle, best friend, coworker, castmate, neighbor, everything wrapped up into one. And that's the sounds of Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You. And yeah, I want more than just... you know, you for Christmas, you know, hook me up with some presents. It's Christmas. 4 days until Christmas. So if you haven't started your shopping yet, you have 4 days. And by now, if you haven't started, it's about to be pretty stressful for you. Like, seriously, if you allow it to be. All right, this is the D. Martez Midweek Entertainment News Show. And on today's show, got some good stuff for you. Of course, Christmas music will be playing in the back. And that's Mariah Carey. Now, that Christmas album, 1994, was released on November the 1st. It is the best-selling Christmas album of all time, selling 15 million copies worldwide. Now, in 1970, Elvis Presley released his Christmas album, and that album sold 10 million copies worldwide. But Mariah holds the title as the best-selling Christmas album of all times, and it's a really good album. Actually, it's one of my favorite. So on today's show, well, got some funny stuff for you. Real Housewife of Atlanta, Cherie Whitfield, drops her new single. And her single is called Who Gon' Check Me Boo. That's right. Who Gon' Check Me Boo. Now, if you watch The Real Housewives of Atlanta, you know that Cherie is trying to get child support from her ex-husband, who's a football player. Cherie is kind of cocky, you know, thinks she's all of that. Kind of has this nasty attitude. And she has a song now. And it's called Who Gon' Check Me Boo. I'll tell you more about it and where the name comes from and all of that stuff. Also, Lady Gaga's Twitter account gets hacked. Yeah, somebody's hacking Gaga. And you know, I also, on Wednesday's show, I do the what the heck? Hello? Yeah, a story that is just like, what the heck? Like, what just happened? And that story today is... a man dies after eating cocaine that was hidden in his brother's butt. Yeah, I know, you're making the same face I did. But first, let's get it kicked off with some Christmas stuff. Because, you know, I like Christmas, and it's 4 days until Christmas. So, Christmas movies. Now, I've compiled a list of Christmas movies that you just have to watch between today and Christmas, and even on Christmas. Okay, so here's my Christmas movie list of some of the greatest Christmas movies ever. A Christmas Carol. I mean, what is Christmas without A Christmas Carol? Come on, Ebenezer Scrooge, definitely. The Santa Claus, starring Tim Allen. The Preacher's Wife, Whitney Houston, that's a good one. It's a Wonderful Life. It is. Miracle on 34th Street. Elf. Remember Elf with Will Ferrell? How the Grinch Stole Christmas, the animated one and the one with Jim Carrey. And, of course, what's Christmas without Home Alone? Now, interesting fact here, Home Alone is the highest grossing Christmas movie of all time, $285 million. And then next comes How the Grinch Stole Christmas with Jim Carrey, $260 million. So that's my Christmas movie list. I will be watching at least 4 of these movies between now and Christmas. And I hope you do the same. So celebrities born on today, December the 21st. Phil Donahue's birthday is today. He's 76 years old. Jane Fonda, She's 74 today. Samuel L. Jackson, 63 years old today. Tennis player Chris Everett, 57 years old today. And he's been in the media a lot lately. Yes. Ex-coach of Penn State, Joe Paterno, 85 years old on today. Okay, so Lady Gaga's Twitter account gets hacked. So Lady Gaga fans saw an interesting but yet strange tweet from Lady Gaga. The tweet said, "Free iPad 2s to each one of you in the spirit of the holidays." Now keep in mind that Lady Gaga has over 5 million followers. Recently, Gaga signed a $10 million deal with Google, but I still don't think that's enough to pay over 5 million iPad 2s. So long story short, Gaga's account was restored, and she tweeted, "Whew, the hacking is over, and just in time, I'm on my way to Japan. So excited to spend Xmas time with my Tokyo monsters." And that's what Gaga calls her fans. She calls them little monsters. Real Housewife of Atlanta, Cherie Whitfield, drops her new single, "Who Gon' Check Me, Boo?" Now in this song, a heavily, when I say heavy, I mean heavily, auto-tune, Cherie says lines like, "Before you say anything else to me, go and fix your grill." And she says, "You're saying you're rich, but I know it's all a mirage." Now, rumor has it that both of these statements are pointed to co-star NeNe Leakes. And, based on the lyrics, how else could you not think that's not NeNe? So, where did the statement, "Who gon' check me, boo," come from? I'm gonna set it up for you. About a season ago on Real Housewives of Atlanta, Sheree was planning this big, extravagant party, okay? And she goes to one of these party planners in Atlanta, sits down with him to plan her party, and basically, like, she's asking him a lot of questions about, the party and the details, and he quite doesn't have the answers. She gets upset. He gets upset. She makes this statement that has now become a song. So I'll play that for you. Here is Sheree Whitfield and the party planner as they get into it, and she asks him, "Who gon' check me, boo?"
"Where's Keisha?"
"Keisha doesn't work. This is my event. You deal with me or you deal with no one."
"How about, I don't want to deal with you."
"Okay, then you need to take your event and your attitude and be checked outside.
Will.
You don't need a reality check."
"No, you need a reality
okay.
check. You don't have the connections, honey. It's Keisha."
"Are you crazy? Google me and do my resume."
You need to get your face out of my face.
"You need to watch yourself before you get checked."
"Who gonna check me, boo?"
So you heard it. She said, "Who gonna check me, boo?" So that statement right there has turned into a song. Now, if you want to get in on the drama of the Real Housewives of Atlanta, be sure to watch Bravo on Sunday. Real Housewives of Atlanta airs 8 p.m. Central Standard Time. But here it is, Cherie Whitfield's song, "Who Gonna Check Me, Boo?" right here on the DeMartez Midweek Entertainment News Show. And there you have it. "Who Gon' Check Me, Boo?" That's Cherie Whitfield's new song. And as you hear, it's heavily auto-tuned. Cherie is rapping. She's doing the background vocals and all of that stuff. You know, that could have actually been the "What the Heck?" it really could have. But no, the what the hell for today is the man. A man dies after eating cocaine that was hidden in his brother's butt. And this is just, yeah, I don't know what to say about this story. But happened in North Charleston, South Carolina. D'Angelo Mitchell is being charged with manslaughter after his brother, Wayne Mitchell, ate cocaine that was hidden in D'Angelo's buttocks and died of drug overdose. Wayne ate the cocaine to save his brother D'Angelo from being charged with drug possession, and D'Angelo is now charged with involuntary manslaughter for his brother's death. Now, ABC Action News reports, "One of us gotta do it. You the only one that don't have any strikes. You my little brother. I'm gonna get life." Now that's what D'Angelo said to Wayne. His brother complied and ate the drugs. When officers saw the cocaine residue on the seat where Wayne sat, D'Angelo told officers that his brother swallowed cocaine. Within the hour, Dwayne struggled to breathe, bled from his mouth, and died. Wow, so this guy ate the cocaine from his brother's butt. That's really like, what the... Now, you know, I understand brotherly love. You know, I have sisters. And, you know, you will do a lot for your siblings. But, you know, a butt, you know, all butts aren't created equal. You know, they come in different shapes and sizes. But one thing about a butt is that a butt has to fart. You know, a butt is gonna fart no matter how plump, fellas, her booty may be. You know, it look good, it jiggle, jiggle, wobble, wobble, but that butt is gonna fart. And you better watch it, because when it does, you know, it may be a little smelly situation. You know, one time I was actually walking by a female. She had a big old booty, you know, big butt. And I did not do this on purpose. Bumped up against her butt. Do you know that butt backfired on me? Yeah, she farted. Yeah. So, you know, butts will do that. Doing the butt. They'll do it. A butt will do it. Yeah, that's Experience Unlimited. Remember that? The butt. Ain't nothing wrong if you want to do the butt all night long. I told you today's show was going to be crazy. Well, after the who gonna check me boo and the guy eating cocaine out of his brother's butt, we need some Christmas music, don't you agree? Here's one of my favorite Christmas songs. It's What Child Is This? And this is by Andrea Porcelli, featuring Mary J. Blige. Absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Andrea Porcelli and Mary J. Blige, What Child Is This? And that's from Andrea Porcelli's 2009 Christmas album that I absolutely love. All right, well, that's it. I hope you've enjoyed today's show, got a good laugh in. Remember Christmas, 4 days until Christmas. And let me just tell you a little something about Christmas before I go. Don't get caught up into the commercialism of Christmas. You know, the gifts and gotta get a present for this one and that one and all of that. Understand the meaning of Christmas, and it's really about the birth of Jesus Christ and the gift that he gave himself to the world so that we could be saved. Make sure you spend Christmas with people that respect you, love you, and who you can be yourself around. That's really, really important. Whether it's your mother, your father, a sister, a brother, could be a really close friend, but surround yourself with those people and give the gift of love. Love is so important because God loves us unconditionally. Okay? So that's my Christmas wish for you. Have a wonderful day. Remember, today is going to be the best day of your life. Something good will definitely happen to you today. Enjoy your weekend. Enjoy Christmas. Watch X Factor tonight and the finale tomorrow. Spread the word about DeMartez, your source for information, inspiration, and laughter. Follow me on Twitter at D_Martez and like my Facebook fan page, that's D.Martez. Okay? All right. Well, I got a lot of stuff in store for you for the new year, and I'll tell you about that on next Wednesday's show. I got on my Christmas socks, and I'm wearing jingle bells. Remember, DeMartez, I love you listening.